It is both an honor and a pleasure to acknowledge this momentous occasion and to congratulate the 56 students who will graduate today. I also want to recognize and thank our esteemed faculty whose dedication to our beloved university and support of our phenomenal students is immeasurable. And now I introduce Fielding Graduate University's president, Dr. Katrina S. Rogers.
On behalf of Fielding Graduate University, welcome to our graduation for January 2021. This graduation is being presented differently, but the essential elements remain the same. Graduation at Fielding is an opportunity for our students to share their stories, to acknowledge colleagues and loved ones, and to feel the experience of having accomplished a significant intellectual challenge. For the audience, it is incumbent upon us to bear witness, to participate as listeners. Having attended many Fielding graduations, themes emerge: the power of family and the relational bonds that hold us together, the importance of our communities that support us, the faith that uplifts many of us, and the determination of our graduates themselves to take on the challenges embodied in higher learning. Reasons are varied, but one thing we have in common is agreement that knowledge and fact-seeking are important elements to professional success across fields. Being able to incorporate scholarship into our professional worlds enables our abilities to have a profound and positive influence upon others. As we embark on our time together today, Leo Tolstoy's story of the three questions comes to mind. Some of you may know this already in encountering them in a children's book or in the original itself. Written in 1885, it is a parable applicable for the world we live in today. The three questions are: when is the most important time? How do we know who we should listen to? And how do we know what is the most important thing to do? His conclusion is that there's only one time that is important, and that is now. It's the most important because it's the only time we have any influence over, this very minute, not past or future. The most necessary person is the person you are with, for no one knows whether they will ever have dealings with anyone else. And lastly, the most important thing to do is to do good, because that is the noblest purpose in our lives. So in closing, I say welcome again to you all to this celebration. Let's begin.
Hello, friends and family. I am Dr. Marcella Benson-Quazina, Faculty Emeritus and former Director of the Organizational Development and Leadership Master's Program. At the master's level, students complete their program with a master's project. The master's research project provides students the opportunity to integrate and apply the knowledge and skills they have learned in the ODL curriculum to an organizational change effort. During the process, we ask them to tap into two critical elements of our core values: their use of self and their passion. So, some of the eccentricities you may have witnessed during their last 6 months as a student is part of their journey. It is my pleasure to recognize the students graduating with a master's in organization development and leadership. Robert Balam, master project entitled Resilience and Interpreters.
I think what's most important is my appreciation and gratitude for Fielding and the program that I went through, organizational development and leadership. It felt like it was tailored towards me. I felt really challenged and I grew so much. And because of that, I want to thank the staff in all aspects of Fielding for the support, the faculty in all my classes, especially Dr. Ruth Middleton House. Without her, I don't know that I would have made it through the program. She brought a perspective, an experience, and creativity and support to me that I couldn't, that motivated me and kept me going. And when it was really hard, support. And then lastly, and most importantly, my husband, who got me through this program, especially the times when I didn't think I could do it. I can't imagine my finishing this program or even my life, what that would look like without him. I love you.
Patrick Charles McNeil, master's project entitled A Serious Look at Play in the Workplace.
Good afternoon, partner graduates, fielding faculty and staff, alumni, family and friends. The only bad opportunities in life are missed ones. I'm not sure where I picked this mantra up, but it's something I strive to do daily. I would like to take this opportunity to thank my wife, Margaret, for her undying and in most cases frustrated support and encouragement throughout my journey. Without it, I would not be here today. Additionally, I'd like to thank friends and colleagues who made the occasional accommodation to schedules, shifting and projects, and their endless encouragement for this older student to cross the finish line. Congratulations again to all Fielding graduates on this auspicious day. Fill your days with curiosity, challenge your assumptions, and have faith that your future will be filled with joy and prosperity. Play is the way, Fielding. Play is the way.
It's my honor to introduce Dr. Kathy Albrecht, whose wonderful dissertation, Taking the Drama Out of Trauma, was one of the first to connect trauma to obesity. Dr. Albrecht is an expert in working with bariatric patients, both pre and post surgery, and her dissertation is a significant contribution to that field in terms of maximizing the chances for success following bariatric surgery. I would like to welcome to the community of scholars, Dr. Kathy Albrecht.
Good afternoon. I'd like to begin by thanking my three daughters who have been part of my entire educational journey. I would also like to acknowledge my grandfather, Boyd Black. He was unwavering in his support of my educational goals and professional dreams. My committee has been absolutely amazing, present and flexible throughout the doctoral process, and I am eternally grateful. Thank you, Dr. Paloff, for leading the effort. I was met with resistance by professionals, weight loss programs, and bariatric practices in carrying out my research. Due to this resistance, I was forced to redesign my study and resubmit to the IRB on a number of occasions. I was able to finish my study utilizing an ethnographic approach. In my early 20s, I worked in domestic violence and rape crisis. I had a boss at that time that influenced my life in numerous ways. She told me once, there is no if, there is no try, there is only do. My ability to bounce back from a number of setbacks in carrying out my research is an example of just do. In closing, I would like to thank my professors and the learning opportunities provided by Fielding. I look forward to future endeavors as an alumnus. Thank you.
It's my distinct privilege and honor to introduce to the scholar practitioner community, Dr. Raymond S. Harrod, Sr.
Good evening. I want to ask my fiance, Ms. Jewel Reed, to place my hood. Thank you. My experience at Fielding Graduate University has been extremely rewarding. I was given the opportunity to do research and contribute to the area of gun violence in the inner city that has impacted my life and many others in a profound way. I was able to successfully engage members of my community and give them a platform to voice their thoughts and personal experiences about solutions and interventions that will hopefully bring about the change that is so desperately needed to save lives. During the process of research and engagement, I was constantly overwhelmed with emotions of anger, sadness, confusion, trauma, and finally hope. Philadelphia has experienced one of its most tragic years of gun violence ever. Moving forward, I will continue my efforts to make the contributions necessary to make an impact on the reduction of gun violence in the inner city. At the end of 2020, there were 499 homicides because of gun violence in Philadelphia. It was exceedingly difficult to listen to the experiences of the persons and families impacted by gun violence while processing my own experiences. I want to thank my family for their patience and support. I want to thank Mothers in Charge, Operation Lipstick, the Charge Foundation, the Black Male Community Council of Philadelphia, and Ceasefire PA. I want to thank the Fielding Graduate University staff, and specifically Four Arrows, for his tough love, encouragement, patience, and undying commitment to help me reach this milestone. Thank you all so much.
Hi, I'm Dr. Jenny Edwards, and I served as the chair of Tina Monomer's incredible dissertation titled The Critical Middle, The Role of Arts and Arts Integrated Technology in Engaging and Motivating the Disenfranchised Middle School Student. Her findings support the core assumptions of the study that when urban middle school students have opportunities to learn core content through arts and arts integrated technology experiences, they become more engaged in class and more motivated in school. I'm pleased to introduce Dr. Tina Monomer to the community of scholars.
My doctoral journey at Fielding has been a rather lengthy one, to say the least. What began as a sprint toward the finish line evolved into more of a stroll as a result of my life events. I'm grateful for the tremendous support I have received from the faculty and staff at Fielding over the years. There have been many obstacles along the way which have interrupted my studies. However, the Fielding community provided the grace and time when needed and were there to support me upon my return to my studies. I'm thankful that through this journey, I've been able to focus my work on supporting the arts in education, which has been a passion of mine for quite some time. I have worked alongside wonderful colleagues and have gained lifelong friends through Fielding. Finally, I want to acknowledge my mentor and chair, Jenny Edwards, who has been a source of strength and support during the many times I have stumbled on this journey. Her gentle spirit has given me encouragement over the years. Thank you, Jenny, for instilling in me the will and confidence to reach my goal. I will always remember whatever it takes.
I'm honored to introduce to the community of scholar practitioners, Dr. Elizabeth Ann Doyle. Her in-depth study of the inequities facing adjunct professors today will hopefully inspire a significant remedy in higher education.
When I started this journey, I thought I finally knew what I wanted. I thought I understood the world and my options in it. Now, I have no idea what to do, but I do have the tools to sit in that uncomfortable space and think and explore and research and figure out what to do. And that's the gift that Fielding gave me, along with that community that allowed me to, you know, cry, complain, be comforted all along the way. I thank you all. And I especially want to thank Eric Jarvie my partner in life, who fed me. He believed in me even when I didn't believe in myself. He listened to me and he celebrated with me at each stage, you know, topic found, research question formulated, proposal written, proposal approved, IRB approved, research started, research done, analysis written, sent to committee, revisions done again, proofreading done, revisions done again, four done, submitted, published, diploma received, doctor hat purchased, a long journey, and one I could not have done alone.
Hello, everyone. My name is Lanil Henderson, and I have the privilege of introducing Lester E. Johnson of Battle Creek, Michigan, who did a marvelous dissertation on a program called Hip Hop for Change, the use of a cultural pedagogy to reach our inner city youth in the public schools of Battle Creek. And this is a program he helped to create. And therefore, he's an appropriate scholar to investigate its structure, its process, and its outcomes. So it is my great pleasure to introduce Lester Johnson to the Academy of Scholars.
Hello, my name is Ellie Johnson. My time at Fielding Graduate University has been so transformative. The coursework, the relationships and interactions with my professors has been transformative and reinvigorating to the extent that my change agentry in my local community in the region of West Michigan, even reaching down to my ministry in Colombia, Ecuador, Peru, and Venezuela, and South America. It has all been impacted, and I'm so grateful to have had the opportunity to fuel my passion and to sharpen myself as a leader through coursework at Fielding Graduate University.
It's my privilege to introduce Dr. Wendy Jean Muhlhauser to the community of scholar practitioners. Her courageous video documentary on teaching empathy through playful teaching and learning will surely inspire many future educators.
Love with no disguise, empathy creates sparkle.
Sparkle.
I wanted to begin with just tons of love. I have so much appreciation first to God. I am incredibly grateful for the opportunity that I have had to play in the playground at Fielding Graduate University. Within the realm of social and ecological justice, I got to contemplate the world and my place within it, especially my place within education and serving children through play. For learning. I also wanted to recognize my dissertation committee, the amazing talent of Anthony Hodakainen, DRS Wayne Judkins. I would not be me without the manifestation within me from the love and the support of everybody in my life. And that includes my interns, it includes my family, beginning with my mom and Connor, my partner Tim, and Peyton and Abby. My friends, my colleagues, my mentors, Sandy Schley, Karen Munson, Hannah Kelberg, and Sylvia Hampton, my agent, publicist more recently. It's really difficult to do this because it's so emotional. Fielding gave me a place to understand that something that I perceived as a limitation is in fact a strength. So I feel that I'm able to go back out into the world after having studied at Fielding Graduate University with a new confidence, a different view of myself and the world. I'm hopeful that my studies have helped me to be able to be more sustainable in serving in our world. For I believe as we preserve childhood, we truly preserve mankind.
It is my distinct pleasure and honor to introduce to the scholar practitioner community, Dr. Talitha Valensky.
Yante blessings, I am Talitha Valensky. I am Kia Ani, born for Hushlishni. My paternal grandfather is Twitich Eatni, and my paternal grandfather is Tkatnizani. The journey for my doctorate started when I asked my father, should I pursue a doctorate? His reply, don't you want to keep progressing in life? His comment was all I needed to hear. Later, my mentor came to be known as Che Four Arrows. My initial attitude was to ease into the program. Nope, I was wrong. Countless hours writing and editing to get my final draft of my dissertation approved with a few hours of sleep. Toward the end, I got infected with COVID-19 while taking care of my two elder parents. My mom was exposed as a nurse assistant when PP equipment pieces were still in order on the Navajo Nation. Four Arrows and I began working diligently on completing the dissertation approval process. At 10 liters of oxygen, I finally agreed to get a PICC line and intubated. In my mind, I thought at least I completed my dissertation. With prayers, I lived through afterlife experience and extubated on the fourth day. I was on my way to recovery. Numerous people reached out to me while I returned home. My mom and I overcame COVID-19 except for my dad, who passed away. Both my parents, brother and sister-in-law, were there in the completion of my doctorate program. Finally, I give all glory to the Creator of the universe for helping me. And thank you for the Navajo Nation in support of obtaining my doctor program. Ikeha.
I'm delighted to introduce Dr. Jennifer Decker to the Academy of Scholar Practitioners. Dr. Decker has written a landbreaking dissertation on the effects of exercising to the point of self-injury of women of middle age. As a personal trainer and owner for a long time of a fitness studio, Dr. Decker has longtime experience and is now moving her career into a new path of studying and improving the lives of women and of physical fitness as a discipline across the nation. In addition, she's made innovations in research methods by showing new ways that qualitative data can be analyzed. I'm so pleased to introduce Dr. Decker, a wonderful scholar, into our community.
I believe it was Dr. Keith Melville who told my cohort at orientation that you don't get a PhD, you become one. Those words resonate with me now more than ever. My research was transformative for me. I studied women who have injured themselves exercising or have exercised with an injury and their relationship with body image. Throughout the entire process, from reading the literature to writing to interviewing and finally data analysis, I learned, among many things, to reframe my mindset from deprivation to nourishment. I have let go of the embedded idea that I somehow need to punish myself for failing to be, for failing to look like the perfect woman. My dissertation work was not only rewarding on a scholarly level, however, also on a very personal one. I will never forget the lessons I learned, as well as the people who supported me along the way to becoming a PhD. I would like to thank my chair, Dr. Valerie Benz, for her guidance and support, my faculty readers, Dr. Connie Corley and Dr. Jenny Edwards, for their invaluable feedback, and my student reader, Whitney Strohmeyer, for her encouragement throughout this process. Additionally, I would like to mention appreciation for my parents for allowing me to be me and go after my dreams. Lastly, I would like to express my deepest gratitude for Thomas for his unwavering belief in me.
I am delighted to introduce Maggie Worrell, who wrote a fascinating dissertation on the psychological factors that could restrain women from reaching senior positions in management. And it's my pleasure to welcome her to the community of scholars.
Supreme Court Justice Ruth Bader Ginsburg, who passed away as I was completing my doctoral research, once said that women belong at all places where decisions are being made. I would add that when women are seated at decision-making tables, better decisions are made. A lifelong student of leadership, I decided to focus my dissertation research at Fielding University into the interplay of gender, power, and leadership, and particularly into those internal factors that help or hinder the advancement of women to senior decision-making tables. Having grown up in rural Australia, I saw very few women seated at top tables, and I realise now that I internalise gendered beliefs about what I could do and who I could be as a change agent. My experience at Fielding has been a really empowering one, and I'm delighted today to be graduating with my doctorate in leadership, but in particular, I want to say thank you to the women who shared their insights into their values, their mindsets, their attitudes that helped them to defy the barriers that so often hold women back. I also want to say thank you to my dissertation committee, but in particular to my dissertation chair, Jean-Pierre Isabout. Thank you so much for championing me every step of the way. I truly believe that to create the world that is capable of existing, we need to have truly inclusive cultures and organisations, and I'm hoping that my research will help to shine a path on the way forward to help more women own the difference their difference makes and rise to top tables. Thank you.
I'm honored to introduce Dr. Mohammed Yusuf Amir to you and his dissertation, Contested Futures, the Emergent Faces of Nationalism in Egypt from Tahrir Square to Sisi's Election. His work traces the multiple actors and reformations of Egyptian nationalism, from the cataclysmic events in Tahrir Square, translated to Freedom Square and known as Arab Spring, that reverberated throughout the Middle East and inspired other liberation movements around the world. This truly brilliant documentation and analyses of the trajectory of Egyptian revolution is a masterpiece, at once scholarly and literary. Please congratulate Dr. Yusuf Amir and welcome him into our communities of scholar practitioners. Dr. Amir, alhamdulillah, u mabruk.
Mohammed, I am very honored and immensely proud to be hosting you today.
Thank you, honey. This is a proud moment for me. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Dear family and friends, faculty and staff, this is a moment I had dreamed of for a very long time. I am so honored to share it with you. When my parents immigrated from Egypt with two kids in tow, to a foreign land and culture, they set forth a sequence of events they could not have imagined. My brilliant and strong sister May and I have been the beneficiaries of their fateful decision. A decision full of sacrifice, but also one of courage, grit, and perseverance. To this day, I remain in awe and forever indebted to my parents, Yusuf and Fatma Aymer. The conversations with my dad brought Egypt's social and political history to life and added even more richness and closeness to our special relationship. And as my mom watches from high above, I can hear her say, "Ya Muhammad, why did it take you so long?" There's another relationship I wish to honor, to my best friend, my high school sweetheart, and partner in life's adventure, Paula Jean. Your support and understanding never wavered. You were the light in night's long darkness. My committee was a doctoral dream. Professor Stephen Zunis brought an unparalleled depth of expertise. Dr. Claude Cloutier shared his insights freely. Professor David Willis performed critical readings of my work every step of the way, and Professor Rich Applebaum challenged me to bring greater clarity and precision to my work. And I would not be addressing you today if not for the unselfish love, support, and wise counsel of my committee chair, Professor Margot Okazawa-Ray. A more talented or inspiring chair does not exist. From day one, she collapsed time and space and problematized epistemology and identity through the mesmerizing music and unmatched voice of Umm Kulthum during new student orientation in Santa Barbara. Finally, I am so grateful to Fielding for his academic rigor and for creating the ideal doctoral environment with the space and freedom to craft a significant and transformative doctoral journey on my terms. Fielding is an extraordinary and inspiring place and community that has touched my soul. Fielding has helped me become a far better human being. Thank you.
I'm happy to be here today to introduce Dennis German. The word I think about when I think about Dennis is kindness, not just interpersonal kindness, but systemic kindness. He's interested in equitable water sharing, particularly for small-scale agriculture. His ethnography studied six small-scale farmers in Goleta, California, and looked at how water policy affected how they could grow crops and feed their neighbors. So what is more kind than figuring out how to equitably deliver water and also grow food? Congratulations, Dr. Dennis German.
It's been a long journey. I began with an analysis of cybersecurity policy, my field of expertise, but changed to water issues since I thought that was much more important. The planet was too big to address, so I looked at Central Valley of California. David, you were right. It was way too big. Thanks for recommending that I focus on Goleta only for my dissertation, as well as bringing your insight to the committee. While I'm giving thanks, thank you, Margot, while working on my concept paper, you kept on saying focus. Rich, thanks for bringing the historical context of the local environmental issues. Mark, thank you for being a great cohort, encouraging and coaching me. Thank you, Casey, for bringing for your years of experience and expertise to the process. And thank you, Annabelle, for your loving, soft touch that pushed me through. And of course, thank you, Elsie and Lin-Lin, for your support, without which I never would have made it. Small-scale farmers are important to the U.S., providing 70 to 87% of the food we eat. Yet, in the Goleta Water District, it seemed policies were devised to favor the majority, 16,000 residential customers, at the expense of this minority, about 2 to 3 dozen small-scale farmers. Not only was this my observation, but it was a story told by my farmers. It reminded me of a phrase from the Bible, "The least of these, my brethren," hence the title. The general big picture takeaway might be that we need to be careful that we don't forget somebody when we devise policy, like the hungry, thirsty, naked, homeless, and unwell, or unjustly incarcerated. We need to see that it is just us. There is no other. If we work together as one for the benefit of all, hopefully we won't miss anybody.
I am Dr. Abigail Lynam, and I served as the chair of Ron Hurst's remarkable dissertation titled Emerging Characteristics of Median Stage Ego Development, when does self-initiated reflection begin? When I think of Ron, what immediately comes to mind is a passion for learning that is unstoppable. His thirst for knowledge led to critical findings about the development of reflective thinking. This work has important implications for developing mature and reflective leaders so needed in our world today. I am so proud to introduce Dr. Ron Hurst to the community of scholars.
Hi there, my name is Ron Hurst. I am so incredibly excited to be with you here today to celebrate with you in this incredible accomplishment. 5 years ago, I was asked a question, Ron, why do you want a PhD? I was shocked by the question. I didn't know. I know now. I wasn't finished. You see, I started my education with an undergraduate degree in engineering, and it really wasn't the perfect degree for me. And I've spent the last 35 years searching for my academic home, and I finally found it in Fielding. To finish with a PhD in the social sciences, and in particular psychology, was a perfect fit for me. All of the community of Fielding, the students, the faculty, the admin, everything about it was exactly what I was looking for, and I couldn't have been happier with the experience I had there. The dissertation that I completed was a crucible. It forged me, it changed the way I thought, it changed who I am, and I'm so grateful for the opportunity to have become. I have lived my life with this deep and earnest desire to help others, to learn, to grow, to overcome the challenges in their life, and I will spend the rest of my career in search of that goal of helping others. There's so many people I want to thank. Most importantly, Abigail Lynam, my dissertation chair, thank you for your guidance, your support, and your unwavering commitment to helping me succeed. To Connie Corley and Keith Melville, thank you both for being on my committee and helping me succeed. To Shelley Hendricks, my student reader, you're an amazing source of inspiration and guidance, thank you. And importantly, to Dr. Tom Murray, for your, as my external reader, you challenged my thinking and took my dissertation deeper when I didn't think there was more to get. Thank you all. To my faculty members who, everyone at the Fielding community, thank you so much. Let me conclude with something that Dr. Miguel Guiarte told me many years ago. He said, you don't get a PhD, you become one. And I can honestly say, I am a PhD.
I was humbled, excited, and inspired by Lisa's visionary work on adverse childhood experiences, special education, and the role of resilience in the life course. Education for all is a key need, indeed requirement, especially now in the challenging era we are in. As Lisa has written, children tracked into special education in public and private classrooms in the United States face many adversities that can lead to negative outcomes in adulthood. Yet there's little research on these complex issues over the life course. Lisa's important study addresses this gap, examining students' needs in school, preparation into adulthood, higher education, and professional attainment. And above all, their resilience, impressive in its depth and breadth intellectually, Lisa's work makes a key contribution to the world of education. Ladies and gentlemen, family, friends, and colleagues, please join me in welcoming to the community of scholar practitioners, Dr. Lisa Melody Mackey.
About 9 years ago, I inquired about getting a doctorate degree at Fielding, and it's been a journey. It's been a long journey. And soon after, I had the opportunity, a per chance hours long meeting with Dr. Cornell West, and I spoke to him about my ideas for a dissertation and working in my field of educational therapy in special education. The dissertation, you know, I've been working on it for a while, completed it, and what was unforeseen is how much resilience I would need to do it. There were a lot of loss, you know, losing parents and all kinds of things during the journey, but my resilience building informed me, my studies, and the work that I will continue to do. And I would like to thank Dr. David Blake Willis, my chair, Dr. Connie Corley, who's on my committee, Dr. Stephen Murphy Shigematsu, Dr. Mindy Rosenberg, and Dr. Richard Laboon for being on my committee and supporting me. I would also really like to thank my family for being so patient, loving, and kind, knowing that this would someday end. And here we are. So the main thing I really want to do is acknowledge my students, past, present, and future, because I'm doing this for you, and I learn from you, and I want to continue doing the work with more knowledge. I would also last like to dedicate this degree to my mother, who was a most resilient woman who worked in the HIV/AIDS field and continued to support all things done positive. So I thank you, Fielding.
I am delighted to introduce Dr. Sarah C. Wallace to you. For her dissertation titled, An Examination of Organizational Congruence, Mission and Practice in Student-Centered Graduate Education, Dr. Wallace reached beyond the typical examination of classroom dynamics between teachers and students. She studied the relationship between the students, faculties, and administrators' understanding of student-centeredness and the organizational and institutional policies and practices. What she discovered is that there is no one definition and that student-centeredness ought to be practiced both organizationally and in relation to students' learning and well-being. Very instructive for our own Fielding Graduate University. Please congratulate Dr. Sarah Wallace and welcome her into our communities of practices. Congratulations, Dr. Wallace.
Hello and good afternoon from Ohio. I did my research on what it means to be student-centered in graduate programs, and about halfway through this PhD journey, I was with a family, we were out shopping, and when I had emerged from yet another bookshop with yet another book on alternative education, my younger sister, in a somewhat bewildered, mildly irritated tone, asked me, "What about all that interests you anyway?" And it is a very good question. Part of the answer is that to me, learning is a gift that energizes and stretches. Individuals who are encouraged and supported in their learning, formally or informally, understand more about themselves, others, and the world around them. They are able to make connections and are creative in meeting challenges. My participants outlined student-centered characteristics that were significant to them and identified organizational approaches that encourage and shape the learning environments, that in turn support students in achieving their goals and administrators in their support of students. My hope is that by contributing to how we understand learning environments, institutions will be able to create more of them that are coherent, accessible, and embrace the learner as a whole person. I will certainly strive to do that in my own work.
Hi, I'm Judy Stevens-Long, and I'm so pleased to introduce you today, Dr. Stephen Hassan, who is an expert in the area of undue influence and cult psychology. He has already authored several books in the area, including Freedom of Mind. And when I met him, he was a member of the program in law and psychiatry at Harvard. His dissertation verified the usefulness of the instrument that he has created to help legal experts define and measure undue influence in a variety of settings. Dr. Stephen Hassan.
So I was persuaded to attend Fielding by Michael Commons at the program in psychiatry and the law because of my desire to help uplift the legal system's understanding of undue influence. And I was a little nervous as a 63-year-old to embark in a doctoral program, but it's been a fantastic experience. I highly recommend Fielding. And my dissertation is hopefully going to help connect the dots with thought reform and brainwashing, undue influence, trafficking, and my BITE model of authoritarian control. And my quantitative study looks very strong, so I'm very excited. And thank you so much to Judy Stevens-Long and all my faculty who helped to teach me.
Good afternoon. I'm Dr. Barbara Mink, Dean of the School of Leadership Studies. It is my pleasure to introduce to the Academy of Scholar Practitioners, Dr. Kevin Lowell. Dr. Lowell has a long and distinguished career as a senior executive in the telecommunications industry. In his doctoral work at Fielding, he expanded his research skills and skills as a scholar to do a dissertation that was both academically rigorous and contributed significantly to the fast-changing telecommunications industry.
The best teacher lodges an intent not in the mind, but in the heart. With that, I want to thank Fielding for creating a program for scholar practitioners. I want to thank Dr. Barbara Mink for all of her support and encouragement and patience. I want to thank Steve Gordon, Joy Friday, my brother Dave, my daughters Anna and Jessica, and my lovely wife Chris, without whom none of this would have been possible. Thank you so much.
My name is John Austin, and I served as Carolyn Meyer's dissertation chair. Carolyn's dissertation was entitled Perceptions of Experiential Learning in a Graduate Practicum Internship. This was a stellar study that was essential because it identified blind spots in how graduate programs understand long-term impacts of graduate experiential learning. I am immensely proud to introduce Dr. Carolyn Meyer to the community of scholars.
My doctoral studies at Fielding challenged me to see the world through a new perspective. The doctoral journey and dissertation drafting process is a big project made up of incremental steps, and each step brought new learning. Many major life journeys are like the dissertation and are made up of small steps that amount to something much bigger. I'm so grateful to the Fielding community for providing me with the opportunity to expand my critical thinking skills as well as my technical abilities as a researcher. Fielding is a beautiful collection of intriguing people and fascinating ideas. It is a supportive yet intellectually challenging academic environment that I'm so glad I became a part of. I can't believe now that I actually put off my doctoral journey at least twice as long as it took me to complete my doctoral studies. Thanks also to the many individuals at Fielding who have helped me on this incredible journey. Thank you especially to my committee for your feedback and encouragement. My heartfelt gratitude to my family, friends, and work colleagues for your tireless support. Thank you in particular to my parents who instilled in me the ability to see beauty and learning in those incremental steps in life. I will be forever grateful.
I'm Dr. Patrice Rosenthal, and it was my honor and my pleasure to chair David Wagoner's excellent doctoral dissertation entitled Coaching for Political Skill. David's research is important because it opens our eyes to a significant reality in organizations, and that is that leaders and would-be leaders need political skill and political savvy to be able to innovate and make positive change. David's research shows us how coaching can be a healthy vehicle for the development of these vital skills. In so doing, David has extended our knowledge base and our evidence base with regard to coaching as an important and developing profession in the world. It is with great delight that I welcome the impressive and the excellent Dr. David Wagner to the community of scholar practitioners.
Hello, my name is David Wagner. I couldn't be more thrilled to earn my doctorate from Fielding Graduate University. This is actually the second time I have graduated from a Fielding program. I am a graduate of the evidence-based coaching program. And when I knew I was thinking about going to get my doctorate, I knew I was going to come back to Fielding. I knew that the faculty would help me make an extraordinary contribution to the literature. And I knew I would learn tips and tools and many, many practices that I could immediately start using in my own coaching practice. Thank you very much to the faculty and staff in Fielding, and a very warm and special thank you to Dr. Patrice Rosenthal, my mentor. I look forward to an ongoing academic partnership with her and to continued friendship. Thank you very much.
I'm Dr. Tanisha Singleton, and I served as the chair on Magdaris Quinones Otero's capstone entitled Promotion of a Healthy Lifestyle in Children Through Adver Games and Conscious Content Development. The work Magdaris has produced is crucial because it illustrates how messages concentrating on the positive benefits and results of making healthier daily choices can produce the desired outcome. Guiding her through this has made me a better storyteller and educator. And for that, I am sincerely grateful to her. It has been my utmost and absolute pleasure assisting her through this journey, and I have all the confidence that she will continue to excel in all of her future endeavors. And I am proud to introduce Magdaris Quinones Otero into the community of scholars. Congratulations.
Greetings, everyone. My name is Magdaris Quinones Otero. I completed my master's degree in media psychology. My educational journey has been one of professional growth and continuous learning. I am grateful for the professors that have taught me and supported me during these last 2 years, and for my family and friends that have been my pillars, cheering me to continue studying despite these challenging times. Thank you, Fielding, for the excellent education that has been provided to me, for innovating with the field of media psychology by providing the tools to target a society that is continuously exposed to social media. With what I have learned, I plan to apply it in my professional career and use it to positively influence the adoption of a healthier lifestyle and prosocial behavior. Thank you.
I am Dr. Kathleen Platzman, and I had the honor of serving as the chair of Belen Camacho's exciting and important dissertation entitled Mentoring for Teachers and Other Educational Personnel. Dr. Camacho's work has pointed the way for meaningful teacher support in these turbulent times. And so I am proud to introduce Dr. Camacho to this community of scholars.
Hello, my name is Belen Camacho. I am a teacher from Ecuador. Today, I want to thank all the faculty members, colleagues, friends, and family who made this dream possible. My thesis holds up the idea that teachers can have access to support through online sessions, an aid that comes from mental health and that many other professions have access to, a type of support that promotes self-awareness, self-recognition, self-fulfillment, self-confidence, and self-care. And that taking into account those elements has the potential to enhance self-efficacy. Now, more than ever, we need this type of help. My wish in this difficult time is that all teachers have access to this type of support to teach, acknowledging the shadows and difficulties of this beautiful but also challenging profession. Thank you.
I'm Dr. Kathleen Platzman, and I had the pleasure of serving as the chair of Christine Clark's extraordinary and important dissertation entitled The Importance of Art for Twice Exceptional Adults, a Chameleon Case Study. Dr. Clark's approach to support for the twice exceptional community serves as a model for use of the expressive arts to bring meaning and enrichment into the lives of one of the most misunderstood and marginalized segments of our society. I am excited and honored to introduce Dr. Clark to the community of scholars.
Fielding has been monumental in my life. It is an invaluable resource for self-driven individuals and for anyone that's interested in a great interdisciplinary community. Everyone that I've met that has graduated through Fielding stands out in the crowd as an individual of change, as an agent in the world. And this is what I aspire to be. And I thank you for your time and efforts and believing in me and everything that I can offer going forward and everything that I hope to do for the world. Thank you. Thank you for your belief in me, and thank you for your support in the change to come. I truly appreciate it. It's invaluable. This education has been life-changing, and everyone that I've met is just absolutely invaluable. Thank you so much. I'm honored and privileged to be here.
This is a very special experience for me because Elvia has been an extraordinary student in our program. For her dissertation, Foster Parents' Capacity in Reflective Thinking, a phenomenological study of foster parents' lived experiences when caring for young children's birth to 5 years. That was the title of her dissertation. When Elvia came into the program, she came into the program as a very unsure professional, and her growth in the program was just phenomenal to watch. It's a great honor to introduce her to the academic and professional community. Elvia, congratulations.
Thank you, Fielding, for allowing me to participate in today's ceremony. I am Dr. Elvia Cortez from the Infant Early Childhood Program with an emphasis on infant mental health and developmental disorders. I defended my dissertation back in March when the coronavirus hit the state of California. I was nervous, confused, and sad, learning the negative impact of this virus in human connections and the cancellation of our graduation ceremony last year. I understood that embracing adversities and engagement to support relationships in my community was critical, and because of that, I supported families of young children in my practice more than ever. We reflected on life experiences. Some are good and others are not the best. However, we agree on what matters is that we learn from each experience and live a better life. Thank you to my professors, mentors, and professionals I met throughout the doctoral studies. I wish you all the best.
It's really a great honor to introduce Patricia Dallas to the academic and professional community. Patricia's dissertation, The Experience of Early Childhood Teachers Who Work with Children with Special Needs and or Behavioral Challenges in Nature and Outdoor Preschools, a Phenomenological Study. This is a special experience for me because Patricia and I grew up in this program together when it first started. So I'm honored to introduce her.
I'd like to say thank you to the children, families, and staff at the Early Years Preschool Program. The idea for this dissertation started on the playground, and I'd like to dedicate this study to the children who taught me about the power of learning outdoors. I'd like to recognize Dr. Stanley Greenspan, the superb faculty of the ICTL Graduate School and Fielding Graduate University for creating such a unique and innovative program for learning about children and families. Special thanks to my dissertation committee, to the mentors, and to my fellow students. We made it. And then also to the teachers who participated and made this study possible. Finally, a note of thanks to my parents, my family, my friends for supporting me along each step of this very long journey, to my nephews who took starring roles in early projects, and to my daughter Molly, who's been with me this entire time. She's been a faithful editor, sounding board, companion, cheerleader, and I just want to remind her of my eternal love. Thank you.
Hi, this is Josh Fader, MD, adjunct professor in the Infant and Early Childhood Development Program in the Department of Psychology at Fielding Graduate University. I'm delighted to present Karen Harris as a candidate for a PhD in our program. Her study on empathy in preschool children was a delightful organic development of the pink pencil test, which is a kinder way of studying empathy in young children. I hope that you will enjoy her description of her research, and I think this work will bring great credit on our department and on the university. Thank you.
Good afternoon. I would like to say what an honor and privilege it is to be here with such esteemed members of the Fielding faculty, administration, students, colleagues, and people that have mentored, taught, supported, and helped us throughout the journey to obtain a PhD. I was introduced to this program when I started researching the books and articles written by Dr. Stanley Greenspan and Dr. Serena Weider. This program has contributed greatly to my career, my learning, the enhancement of the skills that I already had. And I would like to take my dissertation work on empathy with preschool children and continue to help influence the foundation for these young children and future generations. Thank you all, my family, friends, faculty, and God for giving me the ability to do this work.
I am Dr. Mary Warren, and I served as the chair on Genevieve Keating's dissertation entitled, Do Children in Australia Benefit from Chiropractic Care? As a longtime neurodevelopmental pediatric chiropractor in Melbourne, Australia, and educator of other chiropractors, she is committed to helping the whole community understand how chiropractors support the healthy development of babies and children. She analyzed a huge secondary data set of more than 22,000 responses And among her many findings were a ton of voices of grateful parents for how chiropractic care helped their unsettled babies to sleep. I am very proud to introduce Dr. Genevieve Keating to the community of scholar practitioners.
Congratulations.
Thank you. I'm excited to be graduating today. When I was 12, I had a head injury from a diving accident, and chiropractic really helped me recover and gain my life and health back. When it came time to go to university, I was deciding between chiropractic and psychology with children. And I'm grateful every day that I chose the profession that I chose. But this program's really allowed me to study my second love of child development and bring the two together. I'd like to say thank you to my daughter, Bronte Lambert, for her kindness, love, and unending support. To all of my family, including my parents who have passed away, my dad, who gave us conundrums and puzzles and questions, and to any question we asked, he always said, go look it up in the encyclopedia. To my mum, who was calm and patient, and neither of my parents throughout all of my years of schooling ever asked me, do you have homework or should you be studying? This allowed me to find my own inner drive and thirst for learning. To my colleagues, both within my profession and to my fielding colleagues, thank you so much for your encouragement. To Jenny Levitt, who passed away along the journey. She was a close friend and we had promised each other we would graduate together. So I'm thinking of her and she's with us today. To all of the professors who changed the way I think and view the world, thank you. And of course, to my dissertation committee, Drs. Mary Warren, Josh Vader, and Joyce Miller, thank you. I have a deep passion for improving the health and well-being of children and families, and this program has given me the skills and the strategies to be even more effective at that. I'm excited and grateful as a new chapter begins. Thank you.
Yeah, it's an honor to introduce Brandy Kukulov to the academic and professional community. Brandy's dissertation, Fathers' Perceptions of Bonding with Their Exclusively Breastfed Baby from 0 to 12 weeks. Brandy, congratulations.
Hello to the fielding community, family and friends. Thank you so much for being here today. When I started my journey back in May of 2015, this was not how I envisioned graduation to be. However, as with everything else in 2020, I've had to learn to overcome, adapt, and just roll with it. For that, I am so thankful for fielding and your efforts to make this graduation happen one way or another. Thank you very much. I'd like to start by giving a special shout out to faculty who've been with me every step of the way, Dr. Ira Glovensky and Dr. Suzanne McCann. Thank you for all of your support. You'll never know how much I truly appreciate it. I'd also like to thank some peers and lifelong friends that I've made here at Fielding, Diana Osipsov and Dr. Robin Treptow. Thank you for the endless hours of texting and phone calls and support to get through this program one way or another. Most importantly, to my family, my husband, my three children, the third who decided to arrive in the middle of my dissertation, and the rest of my family and friends who've been with me and given me their love and support. Thank you so much. We finally made it. 5.5 years later, I am here, I am done, and I am ready to move on as Fielding alumni. Thank you so much to everybody.
Hi, I'm Dr. Lorraine Ellers-Flint, and I served as chair on Julie McIsaac's wonderful, current, and innovative dissertation, which was entitled, What Were You Thinking? Using Technology to Enhance Mentalization Capacity Among Fathers, a Phenomenological Study. Dr. McIsaac's research was so important and relevant due to its purposes. One was to create a systematic and simple opportunity for fathers to experience mentalization, to think about their child's emotional experience through an easy to understand reflective technique using something readily available, such as accessible technology. Also to expand available research on parenting by fathers and considering the context of interactions and the internal experience of both children and parents. And thirdly, to create an opportunity for positive change in parent-child relationships. It is without a doubt a dissertation that I am proud and honored to have been a part of. And I would like to introduce Dr. Julie McIsaac to the community of scholar practitioners.
Many of us took a risk when we entered this program in its first cohort. It took a lot of time and many life events to get me here, but given the chance, I would do it again. I learned so much, not only from the incredible professors, but also the conversations and feedback among fellow students whose dedication, commitment, and passion is both inspiring and energizing. I will never forget the sound of roosters on Saturday morning class with Dr. Greenspan, Dr. Ehlers-Flint, and Dr. Cordero believing in me as I presented complex family cases, or Dr. Shimon Chinook's beautiful words of wisdom and comfort after a traumatic life event. As I continue on in my professional and personal life, I take with me a deep appreciation and respect for the power of relationship and for the beauty of neurodiversity. Thank you all.
Hi, I'm Josh Vader, MD, adjunct professor in the Infant and Early Childhood Development Program at Fielding Graduate University, and delighted to present Frances Poteet as a candidate for a PhD for her work on the Avicen device. This is groundbreaking work for our program, where she did an independent study of this device that warms one's hand to see if it might help people with autism have fewer symptoms. And her ability to work with the families and track all the different symptoms and compare it to not one, but two different control groups to see if there is any difference is the kind of thing that represents the best of science these days. We need, for social justice and for protection of the patients, to have independent organizations studying the claims of companies when they put out devices. And Frances was able to do that. I'll look forward to her presenting to you her findings. And I am both grateful and honored to have worked with her on this project. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Frances Poteet, and my time in the graduate program began at ICDEL before having the privilege of transitioning to Fielding. Undertaking doctoral studies while tending to the needs of my family and career was not easy, but embracing the challenges as opportunities for growth provided perspective, confidence, and motivation to move forward. My efforts to balance work and life fostered my ability to adjust quickly and frequently to any obstacles encountered. Many thanks to the professors for creating a stimulating environment via thought-provoking material, as well as facilitating lively discussions resulting in content which was immediately relevant to everyone's clinical practice. I am grateful for the opportunity to conduct original research and make a scholarly contribution to science in the field of childhood development and autism. In addition to the excellent faculty, the focus on clinical expertise, integration of cultures, and its span across time zones are other strengths of this program. It's amazing to think that we were years ahead of the world's shift to online learning. When we logged on and connected, fruitful discussions and sharing viewpoints made it truly feel like a small world. Regardless of our background, the common denominator is learning about the impact that emotionally supporting clients and parents has on their well-being. It's incredible how achievements can surpass expectations when individuals feel supported and valued. Thanks to Stanley Greenspan, something that we all take with us and can apply every day, everywhere, is to start where the clients are, recognize each person's uniqueness, and cultivate meaningful interactions. Thank you to my family for inspiring and guiding me all the way to the finish line. Even though I am no longer a student, I plan to continue cultivating my curiosity. Thank you, Fielding.
It's my pleasure to welcome Dr. Tamara Bailey to the community of scholars. She moved from Australia to Los Angeles and then on her internship to Oklahoma and is now back in LA. She will be functioning in private practice as a sports performance medicine psychologist and specializing in anxiety. Her dissertation title was The Moderating Effects of the Valence of Social Interaction on the Maladaptive Psychopathology Consequences of Perseverative Cognitions, an Ecological Study in Major Depression and Social Anxiety Disorder. Welcome to Dr. Bailey.
Thank you for the introduction, Deborah, and for all your time, support, and invaluable advice over the course of my PhD training and research. Thank you to my dearest fellow students, especially Adam O'Neill, and also Elisa and Dominique, Marilyn, Michelle, and Susie, for being the loyal common allies that you are. Loving thanks goes out to my mentor, Dave Shapiro, for his inspiring mentorship. And of course, my heartfelt thanks goes to my parents and to my sister Julie in Australia for all their tremendous, unwavering support that really has kept me strong and resilient through it all. I love you guys so much, and truly none of this would have been possible without you. An extra special thanks goes to my mum for all her loving encouragement, shared laughter, and constant companionship through every page of every chapter of mine, and for all her rousing celebration for every minor victory along the way. Enormous thanks to my dad for his loving guidance and generous support that enabled me to navigate my way through all the pressure and expense of living in the US and affording the privilege of undertaking this PhD venture. Immigrating to the US from Australia to do my PhD was as challenging as it was exciting. So as I stand here today, with my PhD completed, I really am humbled and truly grateful to Fielding for the opportunity of a lifetime to pursue and realize my dream of becoming a clinical psychologist. And I'm forever grateful to my parents who innately cultivated in me the confidence to pursue and realize my dreams. Thank you.
Megan Brubaker's dissertation, Exploring the Relationship Between Social Support and Social Behavior, Moderating Effects of Video Game Use, examined whether video game use affected the relationship between perceived social support and social behavior, and found that children with high perceived social support have better social behavior regardless of how much they play video games. This contributes to a more nuanced view of video game behavior and emphasizes the importance of social support. It is my honor and pleasure to welcome Dr. Megan Brubaker to the community of scholars.
Hello. Although I wish we were all in Santa Barbara celebrating this milestone together, I am grateful to be here. Thank you, Fielding, for taking a chance on me and giving me the most unforgettable 5 years of my life. I am so grateful of the work I get to do now and the lives I get to change. I want to thank my family, my husband, and my son for all the support they've given me through this journey and getting this degree along with me. I hope to see each one of you graduates in the field someday and congratulate you in person. Congratulations, We did it.
I want to introduce to the community Jamie Cruz. Her dissertation is titled, Does Self-Efficacy Moderate the Presentation of Secondary Trauma in Correctional Officers? A Study of Gender. She found that correctional officers definitely experience secondary trauma symptoms, regardless of their gender, and those with more self-efficacy experience less symptoms. This is valuable information for those who do this work, as well as those who support them. It is my great pleasure to welcome Dr. Jamie Cruz to the community of scholars.
Hello, everyone. I am very excited to be here as today culminates a very long and difficult journey for me. I made the decision to maintain full-time employment throughout my time in the program, and I quickly learned why this was discouraged by faculty and advisors. There were many times that I didn't think I was going to make it, and times when I used my study time to plan my exit strategy. Fortunately, I had an amazing support system who was there to keep me going and remind me why I started. The dissertation process was a source of much difficulty and stress, but was made attainable by my awesome committee. Dr. Green, Dr. Vivian, Dr. Hansen, and Dr. Bride guided my research and provided me with everything that I needed to achieve that monumental step. However, the biggest source of encouragement for me was the 24/7 support that I received from my parents. They were there from day one, day or night, to renew my motivation and offer prayers and support when I needed it the most. Along the way, I met my husband, who endured a stressed out partner and a kitchen table littered with books, papers, and laptops, but also knew when I needed a hug or a gentle nudge. So while I am the one who accepts this degree today, I stand on the shoulders of my family, and I am eternally grateful for each of them. Finally, congratulations to all of my fellow graduates. We made it. The day we've worked so hard for is finally here. It's just too bad that we couldn't enjoy a few more legendary Fielding cookies on the way out.
Hello, I'm Dr. Margaret Kramer, and I served as the chair of Nicole Dent's dissertation research. Her study is entitled, The Moderating Role of Pain Tolerance and Fearlessness About Death, meaning the acquired capacity for suicide, in the relationship between chronic low back pain and suicidal behavior. Beautifully conceptualized and flawlessly executed, this research promises to make a contribution to multiple fields of study: pain management, coping and adaptation to chronic low back pain in particular, and the treatment and risk assessment of suicidal behavior in this vulnerable population. It is my great pleasure to welcome Dr. Nicole Dent to the community of scholars. Congratulations, Nicole.
I have met so many wonderful people over the last 5 years as a result of deciding to pursue my doctorate in clinical psychology. I am extremely grateful for all of the amazing fellow students I have met, as well as the incredible faculty at Fielding, and all of the supervisors and clients I have had the privilege to work with during my practicum training. I am also extremely appreciative of completing my internship in Thunder Bay. It was a truly amazing experience. I want to express my gratitude to Dr. Stephen Ruffins. I benefited greatly from his wisdom and appreciated his sense of humor. May he rest in peace. I also want to express my tremendous gratitude to my dissertation chair, Dr. Margaret Kramer, as well as my other dissertation committee members, Dr. Bush and Dr. Reed. I have truly appreciated your knowledge, guidance, and support. Finally, I want to thank my mother, Lucille Dent, for her unending support and encouragement, and to my father, Michael Dent. I wish you were here to see me graduate, Dad. I also wish my grandmother was here to see me graduate, and I miss them both so much. I would also like to thank my partner, Rachel, for being patient and kind over the last 5 years. And thank you to my other family members and to my friends who have continued to be there for me. I am very fortunate to know so many good people. Thanks.
I am Dr. Ray Hawkins, and I served as the chair on Alexandra Elliott's fine dissertation entitled Working Memory Training for Individuals with ADHD, Examining the Factors Associated with Treatment Outcome. Dr. Elliott's work is important because it is an example of the best empirical studies investigating neurocognitive causal mechanisms and their treatment implications for individuals with ADHD. I am proud to introduce Dr. Alexandra Elliott to the community of scholars.
Thank you, Dr. Hawkins. 47 years ago, I met Ray Hawkins and the other members of the Austin Cluster. Little did I know that not only is Ray Hawkins a professor, a researcher, and a clinician, but he is also the one tasked with ordering the cookies. Now, it requires a PhD from Fielding to fully understand the importance of the cookies, but they arrived promptly at 1:30 and they were gone by 1:32. And I know that for graduation, all of us look forward to returning to Santa Barbara and gathering to enjoy returning to where we came. In fact, here is the background I'm returning to, which was the very first class that I took at Fielding, clinical interviewing. I would like to thank everyone who helped along the way, including Ray Hawkins, who is my faculty advisor and dissertation chair, Laura Thompson, my second reader, Jim Vivian, the master statistician, and Walt Mercer, my external reader. I'd also like to thank Dr. Scott Hamill, one of my practicum supervisors. And one thing that you may not know, that in addition to all the support that Ray and the others in the cluster provided, they were also good at solving problems. For example, the time that the bananas served a dual purpose of stopping the blinds from flapping and providing a good snack. So as we return to Santa Barbara virtually, since we can't come in person, I would like to thank everyone and congratulate my classmates on also earning their PhDs. Thank you.
I am Dr. Ray Hawkins, and I served as the chair on Christel Garza's fine dissertation entitled Infertility Journey, an exploratory study of the experiences of women who have undergone fertility treatments. Dr. Garza's work is important because it is a groundbreaking qualitative study of the experiences of women coping with infertility. I am proud to introduce Dr. Christel Garza to the community of scholars.
I would like to take this time to thank all the people in my life who supported me through this journey. My dissertation committee, who challenged me and supported my scholarly growth. My advisor and dissertation chair, Dr. Ray Hawkins. I'm thankful for your incredible support and patience. My mentors, Dr. Jeannie Golden and Dr. Christina Hobby. I'll go through my career following your steps of dedication and commitment to the field. I am incredibly thankful for the relationships I made with my classmates and Fielding staff. This academic journey was worth it because I met each one of you. I also would like to thank my family, my parents, and my brother, who have been great role models of hard work, determination, and dedication to a lifelong learning journey. To my husband, Alfonso, who has always had complete confidence in me, I love you and will forever be thankful to you for supporting me in my crazy dreams and making them your own. And lastly, to the soul of my life, my children, Rafael, Amelia, Eric, and baby Olivia. You give my life meaning, you're the fuel to my life, and the reason to my existence. I will forever be thankful to have you and proud to be your mother.
Well, Dr. Jennifer Greb, it's my great pleasure to welcome you into the community of scholars, introduce you to the world as a brand new clinical psychologist. I was honored to be the chair of your dissertation, a dissertation titled The Moderating Effects of Personal Resilience and Social Support on the Relationship Between Sexual Trauma and Suicidal Ideation Among Active Duty Military Personnel. This was dissertation research drawn from an archival database consisting of active duty military members, and you showed a lot of resourcefulness in finding and using this data for your study. We need much more urgent attention to military sexual trauma, and your research is a meaningful contribution to this critical area. And for that, you should be very proud, as are all of us. Now, Dr. Greb, I know you to be not only a resourceful, resilient, and steadfast doctoral student, and not only a successful military veteran, but in keeping with your courage and resiliency, you are also a former fighter, a boxer. So, in acknowledgement of your toughness and determination, I am sending you my very own Harry Greb boxing trading card. As I have said to you before, I insist you must be related to the great Harry Greb of Pittsburgh, one of the greatest boxers of all time. Since he was a Greb, and you are a Greb, and you're both illustrious people, but he never got a PhD. Here's the card. See? He's wearing a funky outfit, which makes it that much better. And I'm mailing this to you. There you go. I know you're going to do a remarkable job out there as a psychologist, and I am so glad I could be part of your preparation. Go forth, be well, don't forget us. You should be very proud of yourself and all you've accomplished. We are very proud of you.
Looking back on the past 6 years of my doctoral journey, I reflect on significant events that have occurred in my life and as a society. This journey was full of personal challenges, especially the loss of my favorite person, my grandmother, and retiring from military service, on top of the many challenges typically faced by graduate students. These experiences have greatly contributed to my personal growth and have strengthened my passion to serve others the best way I can. I truly believe adversity is what makes this such a reward and accomplishment, and continues to cultivate growth. I have many to thank for supporting me in my academic endeavors. My military family has always encouraged my pursuit and remained rock steady throughout. Many field and professors and staff were instrumental in my academic and professional development, especially Dr. Holland, who guided my research, encouraged my professional goals, always by offering valuable advice. The greatest thing I've realized throughout this journey is that I am now the person I needed most when I was younger. And to me, that's a really special thing. Congratulations, everyone.
I'm Dr. Margaret Kramer, and I served as the chair of Lucia Halagian's dissertation committee. Her research study is entitled Intergenerational Trauma Among Second, Third, and Fourth Generation Armenian Genocide Survivors. This powerful and important study is remarkable for the depth of the formulation and the questions posed, its contribution to our knowledge about the intergenerational transmission of trauma, and the effect of the acknowledgement or disavowal of the event by the perpetrators on the psychological healing and well-being of generations of survivors. I am delighted to welcome Dr. Lucia Halagian to the community of scholars. My hearty congratulations, Lucia.
Hi, I'm Lucia Halagian.
I would like to thank my dissertation chair, Dr. Margaret Kramer, for her unwavering support and guidance. I am grateful for her patience, enthusiasm, and her wisdom. It has meant a lot to me, both personally and professionally, to research the topic of intergenerational trauma among Armenian Genocide survivors. I would also like to acknowledge the continued support of my committee members, Dr. Deborah Bendel, Dr. James Vivian, and Dr. Annie Rogers. I am indebted to their countless efforts and commitment. I am thankful to my late advisor, Dr. Stephen Ruffins. His enduring support was an integral part of why I have made it this far in my academic and professional career. I would like to thank my family and closest friends for supporting me throughout the past few years. My father, mother, brother, uncle, and countless family friends were always there to offer their wisdom, insight, and guidance. I am beyond grateful for the support of my husband, Evan. And lastly, I would like to thank my classmates and congratulate them today. I wish everyone the best in their future endeavors.
It is my pleasure to introduce you to Dr. Kelly Nesto, who comes from Las Vegas and routinely traveled to Los Angeles in the first 3 years of her program, leaving at 3 a.m. to get here to start on time. She's very valued by the ProSAM and has done very well in our program. Her dissertation is The Impact of Intellectual Disability on Rates of Violence and Threats of Violence in a Juvenile Correctional Facility. She will be functioning as a neuropsychologist and a forensic psychologist in the future. Welcome, Dr. Nesto.
Thank you to everyone celebrating with me today during this very unique graduation experience. I wouldn't be here without the love, support, and encouragement of my family and friends. Specifically, thank you to my mom and dad, who always raised me to believe that I could accomplish anything. I'd also like to thank my husband and my daughter for their patience and grace while I completed this program. I'd also like to thank my aunt for joining me on every adventure and being the best travel buddy. Thank you.
Hello, I'm Dr. Mimi Ormerod, and I'm Stacey Papineau's chair of her dissertation, and I was also her faculty advisor for 2 years. Dr. Stacey Papineau has quietly pursued her dreams during her time in clinical psychology at Fielding Graduate University. She stayed loyal to all of the things that were important to her and that define her. Despite the inevitable challenges that life brings, Stacey maintained her identity as a psychotherapist who focuses on trauma work and who has served marginalized and vulnerable populations across her career. Her most recently, she has been providing asylum evaluations pro bono in her own time, along with working for a nonprofit agency running a program that provides mental health services to foster youth. Stacey completed a dissertation that examined bystander intentions and behavior in male college students in relationship to sexual assault on college campuses. She used the theory of planned behavior. Although the findings did not turn out the way Stacey had planned, the journey of the dissertation itself contributed much to Stacey's professional growth and development and informs her practice as a scholar practitioner. Dr. Papineau, I am proud to welcome you to the community of scholars today.
Hello. When I was growing up in rural West Virginia, I experienced significant childhood adversity, and I never thought I would be standing here in front of you today. You see, my family's failures, or as society deemed them at the time, enhanced my focus and concentration on the things that mattered the most, which at the time for me was just to survive. My journey to survive this life began with me joining the Air Force right out of high school. And although my life was challenging, I knew I didn't need magic to transform my world, and that I already had everything I needed inside of me, because I had the power to imagine a better life for myself. My better life now includes Shane, Zachary, Ashton, Chad, and Doug, all of whom supported me tremendously throughout this whole process and this journey. You see, my first degree that I earned was 20 years ago. And the reason this achievement is so significant is I was the first person in my family that ever graduated high school, let alone went on to attain higher education. You see, somewhere along the way, I stopped surviving and I started living. I had the capacity to dream, and I sought to create change and be a catalyst for how we view interpersonal violence and mental health as a part of our culture. To speak for those who are unable to speak for themselves, and to create more understanding and acceptance for mental health and healing from within. Having lived all over the world, I've learned that it's the hard days that challenge you to your very core, and that's what helps determine who you are. So what I know is that helping others has helped me more than anything else, and that finding gratitude and appreciation has been the key to my own resilience. I don't have the words to express my gratitude and appreciation for all of my supporters. I am indebted to my past supervisors and mentors for their generosity and wisdom. Dr. Umarad, I am forever grateful for your patience and your support throughout this whole dissertation process, as well as the rest of my committee for their time and commitment. With these thoughts in mind, I proudly and humbly stand before you to accept this doctorate. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Dr. Tiffany Field. I was the dissertation chair for Kosha Ann Peterson, whose dissertation was entitled Adaptive Skill Benefits of Peer Exposure for Children with Autism Spectrum Disorder. Her dissertation is extremely important for highlighting the significance of children with autism having opportunities to play with their peers. I would like to welcome Dr. Peterson to the community of scholars. Congratulations, Kosha.
I want to take this time to sincerely thank all the people in my life that supported my journey with Fielding. I remember the first time I sat down with Marty Kranzberg in her Dallas office to talk about the educational opportunities this university could offer me. I'm so thankful for the relationships I have with my fellow classmates and the support provided to me by Fielding faculty and staff. I'm immensely grateful for my dissertation committee. They really challenged me. I also want to thank my family. My parents blessed me with all the confidence I ever could need to work towards my goals, and my three sisters are my greatest cheerleaders. My husband, Adam, was always willing to pick up the slack at home when I needed to prioritize my education, and I know that was a big challenge as well. I am certain that my education at Fielding has contributed to my ability to serve my clients and my community. Thank you all.
I would like to introduce to the community Angelina Prince, whose dissertation began under the direction of the late Dr. Stephen Ruffins. She titled her work, Exploring Moderators and Factors That Influence the Impact of Child Sexual Abuse on Internalizing and Externalizing Behaviors. She looked at how age and type of abuse related to the later expression of emotions and conduct in a large sample of children. This work contributed another look at the long-term consequences of this unfortunately all too prevalent phenomenon in society. It is my privilege to welcome Dr. Angelina Prince to the community of scholars.
When I started this PhD journey 6 years ago, I pictured this moment in my head a million different times. Walking across the stage to get my degree, my friends, family, mentors, advisors, all in the audience. And today, it's a far cry from what I expected. But I'm so appreciative of this moment as I accept my PhD in clinical psychology. As I'm standing here right now, I'm humbled. I'm grateful. I'm triumphant because I easily could not have been here. Now all the sleepless nights and the homework, endless hours of studying, the imposter syndrome, two major surgeries, two major catastrophic Category 5 hurricanes, the months without power, losing my mother? That shattered the ground that I walked on, and I wanted to quit. I wanted to give up. But my mother, Nancy, Jean, Holloway, Prince, Faria da Costa, she never gave up. To all of my friends and family, to my mentors, to all my advisors, to anyone who pushed me along the way, to my fielding community, to my Virgin Islands community, thank you. I couldn't do it without you. I wouldn't be here without you. To the dearly departed Dr. Ruffins, who was my dissertation chair, Dr. Henry V. Soper, you too should have been seated in an audience, but you're no longer with us. Thank you for every joke, for all of the knowledge, and for being there when it mattered most. I want to leave you with a few words that my mother imparted on me. She said, "You're succeeding, and as a result, you can help other people to succeed. It's not about what you can do for yourself. It's about how much of yourself you can give to others." And that's exactly what I intend to do. Thank you.
Hello, I'm Dr. Mimi Ormerod, and I served as Leslie Roberts' faculty advisor and her dissertation reader. Leslie's journey, like so many others, demonstrates evolution in not only her professional development, but also in her approach to scholarship. I have had the pleasure of interacting with Leslie at all stages of her academic journey. She was a member of my first student cohort at Fielding and my first research practicum. At the start of her doctoral degree, Leslie studied the policies and requirements for the doctoral program like others study for exams. And she was on a fast track to tick all of the boxes and graduate as quickly as possible. However, around the third year, she embraced slowing down and becoming present-oriented as much as she was future-oriented. This worked well for Leslie across all spheres of her life, and it especially allowed her to delve meaningfully into her dissertation entitled "The Psychological Impact of Mandated Registration of Youth Sexual Offenders." The dissertation, chaired by Dr. Sanford Drobb, is a fascinating qualitative exploration of adolescent sex offenders who had been mandated to the registry during their childhood and the effects that this had on them from adolescence to adulthood. From the data, Dr. Roberts created a new theory called the four dichotomous state theory for youth sex offenders. I hope that she will publish this work as it is a novel perspective about youth sex offenders and deserves a place in the literature. I am very proud to welcome you today, Dr. Leslie Roberts, to the community of scholars.
When I applied to grad school all the way out in California, I had no idea what I was getting myself into. And after I attended my first week of orientation in Santa Barbara, I was pretty overwhelmed. I learned real fast that first year of my PhD program that getting a doctorate is a lot like mountain climbing. You just have to look at the next thing in front of you, as opposed to the enormity of all the things you still have to get done. I'm really fortunate that I came across a school like Fielding that allowed me to not only pursue my dream, but not have to quit my life in doing so. Despite the time away from my family and all the stress of getting coursework done while working and learning how to post on an online forum, Fielding really allowed me to not only pursue my dreams, but also engage in my relationships with those in my community. It turns out as a practicum student, it's not very difficult to form these relationships when you're willing to work for anybody for free. Aside from that though, I really made great relationships at Fielding with my professors who live in California and New York and Chicago, but also my fellow colleagues who live closer, like Dr. Glass and Dr. Connell, to even ones that live farther away, like Dr. Vera, who practices in Canada, and I literally talk to every day as we both work hard to build private practices. Most importantly, though, I would have never been able to achieve this dream if it wasn't for the support of my husband, my children, my parents, and many, many aunts and uncles, because it truly took a village for me to achieve this dream. For all your love and all your support and all your time, I will forever be indebted and thankful for you. I love you. Thank you.
I once compared my journey mentoring Erica throughout this program as feeling like the jockey for Bodhi Express, the strong-willed, determined horse who threw his rider off and proceeded to run the Kentucky Derby full speed ahead. Or my memory of her tracking me down at winter session and insisting we map out her entire dissertation, because about an hour later, I realized that she was only a first-year student. Erica and I can laugh about these stories now because she's always asked for and benefited from being pushed and slowed down when needed. And I felt so honored to witness her growth, persistence, and dedication to becoming a professional psychologist. Thank you, Erica, for your work in this program and for helping to develop the Black Student Association, helping to put together Play Recess at National Sessions, and all the words of appreciation that followed the toughest mentoring sessions. It was with great honor that I welcome Dr. Erica Sotilio to the community of scholars. Congratulations.
Greetings, distinguished guests, graduates, faculty, family, and friends. My name is Dr. Sotilio, and I hold a PhD in clinical psychology from Fielding Graduate University. I am now a postdoctoral fellow in the Navy. It is an honor to be here with you today, albeit virtually, during these very challenging times. When reflecting on my journey at Fielding starting in 2014, there are two terms that come to mind. One, I am immensely blessed, and two, toughness pays off. But it wasn't easy. It was like being on a ship. I could only see with my mind's eye, not my natural eye, a beautiful destination just beyond the horizon. But there were no guarantees. I could have easily abandoned ship. Why didn't I? Because of my support system. First, I thank my higher power and those who prayed for me, especially Ma and T. Linda. Thank you, Mom and Dad, for teaching me the value of education and the power of prayer. Thank you, Dad, for letting me know that with hard work, one day I could be a psychologist. And Mom, thank you for always reminding me to speak life. My siblings, Felicia, Arthur, Annie, instrumental in my growth. My advisor chair, favorite mentor, AKA Wonder Woman with quite the equestrian skills, Dr. Harris Britt. I definitely could not have made it this far without being under your direct leadership. Other dissertation committee members, Dr. Moore, Luban, Vivian, and Green. Dr. Green gave my cohort a bracelet in 2014 at New Student Orientation, and it says, to me, the story behind the bracelet represents diversity in the field of psychology. Realized through toughness, one of the Navy's core attributes. Toughness is taking a hit and keep going, tapping all sources of strength and resilience, rigorous training, and steadfast support of family. We don't give up the ship. This is my journey with Fielding, and I did not give up the ship. Lastly, to my grandma who transitioned, I know you will always be here rooting for me in spirit. Congratulations, graduates. Remember, no matter how challenging life gets, keep the faith by speaking life. Great things are just past the horizon. Do not give up the ship.
Hello, I'm Dr. Jerry Lynn Hogg, and I'm pleased to introduce Dr. Dave Kaplan. His dissertation was entitled, Film Stories and Empathy, Do Pro-Social Characters Make an Audience More Empathetic? The results of Dave's dissertation research shed light on the importance of pro-social effects of the telling of visual stories. These include the benefits, even healing, power of story for societal change. Dave is an award-winning television writer and executive producer of popular primetime comedies, so he's perfectly poised to directly implement the results of his research and create positive impact. Dave, it's been my honor and privilege to work with you as your dissertation chair. Your research is having immediate and direct impact now, and I expect will have far-reaching positive influence for many years to come. It is my great pleasure to welcome you, Dr. Dave Kaplan, to the community of scholars.
Thank you. I never really felt like I got enough education as a young man, and that was partly life circumstance, partly limited resources, partly limited maturity. I eventually got the degree I needed and it served me well, but I always felt a lingering dissatisfaction that I was capable of more and wanted to be challenged. But we're taught that if you miss that chance, well, them's the breaks. But places like Fielding are at the vanguard of changing that way of thinking. I took one Fielding class at night and I was fascinated, so I took another. And then an advisor contacted me and told me what I needed next for my master's degree. And I replied, I'm getting a master's degree? I guess I'm getting a master's degree. And when I graduated with the master's degree, Jerry Lynn said to me, you're getting your PhD, right? And I said, I'm getting a PhD. And then I thought, why live with a lingering dissatisfaction? I'm getting a PhD, and here I am. It's been a privilege to chase this dream with my Fielding colleagues and fellow graduates, and I appreciate your support and wisdom, and congratulations to you too. I, of course, owe a great debt of gratitude to my wonderful dissertation committee, Dr. Robin Nabby, Dr. Dan Sewell, Dr. Pamela Rutledge. Thank you for all your help and support. And Dr. Jerry Lynn Hogg, my chairperson and advisor, without whom I simply could not have done any of this. She's always available despite a relentless schedule and always present despite ridiculous demands. You made me believe I could do this. Thank you. My family also made this possible for me. My mom's inspiration and the support of both my sisters was hugely important. My daughter Kenzie is pursuing her own psychology advanced degree, and whether she was actively helping me or just talking shop, she was invaluable. My son Corey was by turns my proofreader and intellectual partner, and whatever crazy psychosocial economic philosophical theory of the week I had, he always told me where it was wrong and what I needed to do to shore it up. And none of this was remotely doable without my wife, Candy. She encouraged, cajoled, pep-talked, supported, and did whatever was necessary to get me here. She's my rock, and I thank my lucky stars for her every day. Again, thank you.
I am Dr. Pamela Rutledge. I am pleased to introduce Dr. Corey Emanuel Chapman. His dissertation was entitled, The Black Excellence Mindset, Black Media Consumers' Perceptions About Aspirations and Black Macro-Level Influencers. The increasing visibility and cultural impact of Black-led entertainment inspired Corey's timely and important research. Corey explored how Black media consumers choose and relate to celebrity role models, and further, how those choices inform Black media consumers' attitudes, behaviors, and goals. Corey, this was a long journey, and I commend your persistence and commitment. It has been inspiring watching your passion for Black-led media emerge as such a scholarly achievement. Dr. Emanuel, congratulations. I welcome you to the community of scholars.
For the past 6 years, Fielding faculty and colleagues, many of whom I now call friends, have enabled me to see myself as much more than a doctoral student. Instead, they've empowered me to become a better educator, mentor, citizen, and thought influencer. Writing and completing a dissertation in the midst of a global pandemic is no small feat. It required a lot of courage, dedication, and quite frankly, a level of mental fortitude that I didn't even know I possessed. I have to thank not only the amazing Fielding faculty for always cheering me on, but a host of family and friends for always supporting me and believing in me. I'm convinced now more than ever that really anything is possible when you pursue goals that are aligned to your purpose. My purpose is to empower, inform, and uplift those around me by harnessing everything that I learned inside and outside of the Fielding classroom. This has been one of the most challenging but yet rewarding experiences of my life. I'm truly excited for what the future holds. Warmest wishes and thanks to all of you. Stay safe.
Hello, I'm Dr. Jerry Lynn Hogg. I'm pleased to introduce Dr. Tatiana Elcor. Her dissertation was entitled Digital Behavior Response in Augmented Reality versus Non-Augmented Reality Context, a Randomized Control Trial. In her research, she found digital information relayed in augmented reality contexts was more influential in stimulating desirable digital behavior response towards correct message over time when compared to non-augmented reality contexts. As an expert in global health with over 20 years of experience at the United Nations in global healthcare and with humanitarian organizations, Tatiana will be able to directly use her research findings to inform her work. It should be noted that while Tatiana was at Fielding, she received the Mike Neal Legacy Award, Lifetime Membership in PsyChi International Honor Society in Psychology, Worldwide Network for Gender Empowerment Research Fellowship, and the Wingenheim Endowment Scholarship for International Doctoral Students. She also made significant contributions to academic literature with journal articles, book chapters, and prestigious academic conference presentations. Tatiana, it's been my honor and privilege to work with you as your dissertation chair and co-researcher on numerous research studies. Your research will have far-reaching positive global impact for many years to come. It is my great pleasure to welcome you, Dr. Tatiana Elcor, to the community.
Mabruk. Mabruk.
My name is Tatiana Elcor, and I am from Amman, Jordan. I'm a firm believer that God shapes us to do great things in life. And one of the greatest things that happened to me is to be part of the Fielding community and to also be able to successfully complete my doctoral education through Fielding. My research focuses on how people interact with media and technology to change their health and nutrition behavior. And what more pressing time than our times these days, when media and technology became mainstream, and when pandemics as well are a part and parcel of our lives. I also wish to thank Fielding for being able to continue my education while also serve my own people, people who are living at the brink of war, refugees, internally displaced, those living without gas, water, electricity, and under extreme conditions, and even without digital access. One would wonder, how would you continue your education under such conditions? But Fielding made it possible for me, and to that end, I am most indebted and grateful, and most indebted to my dissertation committee, and would like to thank my parents, my father, and my mother, and my family at large. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Dr. Karen Shackelford, and it is my honor to present Dr. Carlos Allende Gonzalez. I was Carlos' dissertation chair. He is an excellent scholar and a great friend, and he has done so much for me as a research collaborator that when I found this opportunity to get one of my favorite bands, Bandits on the Run, to record what is called a virtual singing telegram, I told them all about Carlos, and they recorded this for him. Carlos, welcome to the community of scholars. I'm so proud of you. And now, Bandits on the Run.
Hey, Carlos.
Hey, Carlos,
the scientist. You're published and so clever.
So clever.
And Carlos,
Carlos,
you're the kindest. You help Karen in all of her endeavors. It's a wonder you're so humble with your beautiful hair. You make Karen right in there because you really do care. She sends all of her love above the world to you and Terry. T'Challa will be proud and thank you very, very, very much. Oh, Carlos, oh.
I started a master's in the media psychology program in May of 2015. Before the end of the first week, I wanted to quit. I couldn't understand how Moodle worked and the readings were too difficult. I earned my master's degree 2 years later, thinking that only a masochist would go for a PhD. I ended up going for a PhD. I got my official degree last May. Now I'm trying to get a postdoctoral position. Looking back, getting a PhD wasn't that difficult. All it took was to give myself permission to fail, just not before a trimester ended. Thankfully, every time that a trimester ended, I reconsidered. Now I'm teaching something similar when I cover conflict in storytelling, how small victories can help us reduce fatigue, keeping us engaged. I learned a lot and I made a few good friends at Fielding. Thank you, Karen. Thank you, Pam. Thank you, Jerry Lynn. You are my heroes. Thanks to my husband too. He's my captain. Thank you very much.
Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Regina Tuma, faculty in the Media Psychology Doctoral Program. Today I have the pleasure of introducing Joanna Hethketh. Joanna's research explores how identity-based relationships between viewer, film, and product can lead to purchase behavior, thus introducing a self-media product model to marketing in films. Joanna, I'm not sure if you remember that I was the one that actually interviewed you when you first applied to our program. And it has been a pleasure to see your growth and development throughout your journey and to be there with you. And so, it is my honor, Joanna, to welcome the newly minted Dr. Joanna Hethketh to the community of Fielding Scholars. Congratulations.
So I began this journey too many years ago to admit in Santa Barbara with a phenomenal group of humans that were so brilliant and intimidating that I really questioned whether I was cut out for this. Little did I know that that day would lead to the addition of a wonderful family of superwomen that I will eternally be grateful for. Our sessions in Santa Barbara, spent mostly at a beach house somewhere along the coast, were inspirational and life-changing as we navigated classes, challenges, and life in general. I got lost a few times along the way, and my village of superwomen were always there to help navigate me back to where I needed to be. But I also came into the program with an amazing village of people to start with. My unconditionally supportive parents, who I'm so blessed to have, my unwavering cheerleader of a sister, and the most phenomenal best friend that anyone could ask for on the planet. I couldn't have survived this without you. I have so much gratitude for you all that I really can't even begin to express. I would also like to express my gratitude to my committee, especially Dr. Dan Sewell, for stepping in partway through and helping me get back on track. And to my chair, Dr. Regina Tuma, thank you for seeing this through to the end. But you know, really this journey wasn't just about getting to that final submission, that approval of the file in the end. Yes, that was the goal, and yes, I got there. But this journey was so much more than that. And I'm really grateful for every moment of it, even the really, really hard bits. Mostly because I never had to do any of it alone. So thank you so much to my village. I 100% share this moment with all of you today. I love you dearly. I am eternally grateful for you. And I'm so blessed to have you in my life. Thank you.
Hello, I'm Dr. Jerry Lynn Hogg. I'm pleased to introduce Dr. Greg Moore. His dissertation was entitled Word Usage Bias in Facebook Communities, a Psycholinguistic Analysis of Political Commentary. Greg's dissertation explores the effect of political bias, Facebook user comments on news articles. In particular, he examines sentiment of word usage patterns and biases in opposing political affiliated Facebook communities around major news events His research expands the research on the effects of news and community biases have on social media users. Greg, I've enjoyed working with you as your dissertation chair. It is my great pleasure to welcome you, Dr. Greg Moore, to the community of scholars.
When I first thought about getting a PhD, I asked myself if in 10 years I'd look back and decide it was worth giving up all the nights and weekends, hobbies and vacations. And now that I'm 5 years away from that 10-year mark, I'm excited to see what doors are going to open and what doors were closed that I didn't even know existed. So I'd like to thank the professors and the fielding staff, my friends and my family who helped me get through this journey. And I look forward to seeing what's next. Thank you.
My name is Dr. Pamela Rutledge. It gives me great pleasure to introduce Dr. Elizabeth Murphy. Her dissertation on meaning-making, connectedness, and legacy, examining the benefits of digital storytelling for older adults, was a qualitative study using constructs from positive psychology to examine self-reflection through storytelling. Elizabeth's dissertation grew out of her experience with the elderly and her recognition of the many differences between those age 65 and those 80 and beyond, and the impact that those differences can have on well-being. Her study is one of the first to address the impact of shared stories on well-being, sense of connection, and meaning-making among these older adults. The pandemic made her research project all the more challenging to conduct, but all the more important to do. Her work is an important contribution to a society with a growing number of vital 80-plus seniors and the rise in loneliness and depression from the extended period of social isolation due to COVID-19. Dr. Murphy, it has been a joy working with you throughout the program. I welcome you to the community of scholars as a colleague and a friend.
Thank you, Dr. Rutledge. You've been an amazing mentor, guiding me through two research projects and a dissertation. Thank you for your leadership. Dr. Jerry Lynn Hogg was my research expert and faculty mentor. She's been with me on this journey in so many ways. Thank you. I was also very fortunate to have Dr. Oler as part of my committee. The guidance and support from these three enabled me to put the pieces of my past experience in education into my own story, and I am profoundly thankful. It is here at Fielding that I was able to pick up where I left off some 20 years ago. The experience has been amazing, with a wonderful media psychology faculty who have all been part of my success. I was also truly blessed to have a fabulous cohort. From this group, I developed research collaborations with my research partner, Sarah, a dissertation champion with Carrie, and an independent study partner, Jay. You've all been immensely supportive. Thank you, friends. Before many of us even embark on a path like this, we have to have the support of our families. This accomplishment for me is particularly sweet to have finished my PhD with adult sons who championed me throughout the last few years. Grant, with his quiet and unwavering encouragement at every call, and Parker, who'd procrastinate with me, but also push me to get back to work when I really needed to. Thank you too to my dad and my aunt, who have been genuinely interested and who both ask a lot of questions, which forced me to know what I am doing and how to tell others. My mother has been a personal cheerleader and reaches higher for me than I do myself sometimes. Thank you too to my husband, Brian, who supports my dreams and endeavors and who has given me the luxury of lifelong learning and appreciates the intangibles. Thank you for your love and support. Our stories are never finished and we need stories to connect with others. I am full of gratitude for my friends, colleagues, and family that have listened to mine and encouraged and supported me to continue to write new chapters. I encourage you to do the same. Take time to listen to someone else's story and continue to write yours. Thank you.
Hello, I'm Dr. Jerry Lynn Hogg, and I'm pleased to introduce Dr. Angela Patterson. Her dissertation was entitled Screening, faith, the impact of media and technology on faith development of adolescents and young adults. Angela's dissertation explored religion and spiritual development for adolescents and young adults, and what digital media exposure factors influenced their faith development. Now, originally, her research was designed to be collected both in person and online. Angela had to alter her data collection due to COVID. She did so and was able to uncover valuable information on the potential influence of media in accelerating faith development for Gen Z. Angela, it's been my honor and privilege to work with you as your dissertation chair. It is my great pleasure to welcome you, Dr. Angela Patterson, to the community of scholars.
My name is Angela Patterson, and I'm sitting in the historic sanctuary at First United Methodist Church of Dallas, where I serve as the Director of Communications. Early on in my fielding journey, during my media psychology master's program, I began to see the intersections between media psychology and how we develop and maintain our spirituality. Our beliefs, regardless of the nature of them, are a core part of who we are. And with media and technology all around us, I felt pulled to understand more about how this institution of media in our society affects what we believe, what we choose not to believe, or whether we believe at all. So much of what I've learned during my master's and doctoral work at Fielding has been put into practice right here at First Church, as I was able to offer communications that helped this congregation stay connected to God and neighbor. And that work has only been magnified during this season of COVID. My fielding experience has been transformative, and not just because it gave me an avenue to live out my purpose. It's exciting to be at the forefront of a discipline that's still forming and evolving, and all of our individual studies contribute to this larger entity that is media psychology. As our lives become even more intertwined with technology, our work becomes all the more relevant. I am grateful to all of the faculty who have lent their talents to helping us prepare to become leaders in this field. And I'm especially grateful to Drs. Jerry Lynn Hogg, Dan Sewell, David Peck, and my external, Dr. Andy Stoker, for preparing me to hopefully become a lifelong learner and thought leader in media and spirituality. I'm also grateful for my friends and family who supported me along the way. I'm thankful for my fielding experience, and I'm looking forward to what is to come.
My name is Dr. Pamela Rutledge. I am delighted to introduce Dr. Olga Valentin. Her dissertation entitled Savoring Positive Experiences on Instagram drew from positive psychology to explore the construct of savoring and its impact on well-being and the enjoyment of meaningful experiences. Olga's dissertation is one of the first to examine the positive potential of digital communications and the documentation and sharing of experience through image. Olga, I know this was a longer journey than you expected. You did take some brief detours to get married, move, remodel a house, and have a baby. However, you got it done. And your results showing that savoring predicted enjoyment of positive experiences is timely, as social isolation has increased the use of Instagram and visual imagery to maintain well-being and social connection. Dr. Valentin, congratulations. I am so happy to welcome you to the community of scholars.
All right, well, this is not exactly how I envisioned graduation to be, but here we are. I'm still grateful to finish this crazy journey. It's been a test of perseverance and patience, and certainly taken me a lot longer than I anticipated, but I'm so thankful to my entire support team because I couldn't have done it without all of you. So first and foremost, I really want to thank my committee, Jerry Lynn Hogg and Pam Rutledge. You both have been the most inspiring mentors to me, and thank you so much for pushing me and encouraging me and not letting me fail. And thank you for reminding me when I'm overthinking things. That was real key. Thank you to Jason Oler and Amy Blankson. Thank you for your time and for all of your kind words. It really made a difference. A special thank you, of course, to my mom, who really nurtured my love of psychology in the first place so many years ago. And I'm really proud to now be the second Dr. Valentin in the family. And thank you to all of my other friends and family who just stood by me for so many years and encouraged me and just loved me. Thank you. I love you all so much. To my kids, my little toddler, 2-year-old Mikey and baby girl who's growing in my belly right now, I hope that I make you proud, and I hope that this inspires you one day to do hard and creative things in your life. And finally, thank you to my husband, Michael. You have held my hand every step of the way and really pushed me and encouraged me, and it's meant the world to me. Thank you for helping me chase my dreams and reminding me of what those dreams are, even when I doubted myself. You're the best life partner ever. So thank you all who've been involved in this journey. I really couldn't have done it without you all, and Fielding, this was quite an experience.
Thank you. Yay! Great job.
Yeah.